SchoolFreeware's QBasic Tutorial Series, Tutorial 48. The Bouncing Ball Animation. The code used within this tutorial is not compatible with QBasic. This tutorial uses QB64 running on Windows 7, and the code can be downloaded at schoolfreeware.com. On the desktop here, I have a picture of a ball that I drew in Gimp. This picture is a ping image with the dimensions of 50 by 50. I'll go drop the ball into the QB64 folder, and I'll start QB64. I'll start by declaring image as a long. We'll then need an x and y coordinate, so I'll declare x as integer. I'll declare y as integer. Next, we need a variable to determine if the ball is moving up or down. So I'm going to declare move up as an integer. And this variable will work as a boolean. The next variable is move right. Move right is an integer. And when move right is equal to 1, we know that the ball is moving to the right. And when move right is equal to 0, we know that the ball is moving to the left. I'm going to make the screen 800 by 600. And the screen will be 32-bit color. I'll start x off as 0. Y will start off as 0. So therefore the ball will start in the upper left-hand corner. I want the ball to move down, so move up is equal to 0. And I'll start the ball moving to the right, so move right will equal 1. I'll then load the image, so image equals underscore load image, and the image name is ball.png. The program will loop until the user presses a key on the keyboard, so I'll start do loop while in key $ is equal to two quotations together. So as soon as somebody presses a key on the keyboard, the program will stop. Within the do loop, we'll put our code. So I'm going to start off with put image x, y for the coordinate, and then image for drawing the ball. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and run this at this time. And we see that the ball is drawn in at coordinate 0, 0. But it's not moving at this time because x and y are not changing. So if I were to go ahead and put x equals x plus 1 and y equals y plus 1, the ball now should move. So I'll go ahead and run. And we see that the ball has moved across the screen and left its trail on the screen here. So I'm going to close this down. And what I'm going to do is see if I can slow the ball down by putting a limit for the repeat rate. So limit, I'm going to set the repeat rate to 30. So now I'll go ahead and run. And we see that the ball is now moving, but still leaving a trail. So what I'm going to do is pcopy the display. So I'll put in pcopy underscore display. And I'm going to need a number. I'll have number 1. We will put the image. And then I'll pcopy number 1 back to the display. Go ahead, run, see what I get. I get a blank screen, and that is because I need to put an underscore display here, and I'll run again. And now that we can see that the ball is moving down, if I wish the ball to move faster, I can increase the limit. So So I'll increase the limit to 100. The ball moves faster. I can also change how many pixels the ball will move at one time. So instead of having one, I can have 3 pixels at a time with the limit of 100. Ball moves pretty good at that point. So now what we need to do is work on hit detection. So I'm going to delete this X and Y lines here. So I'll start by hit detection for the right hand side of the screen. So if the coordinate X that is greater than or equal to, since the screen has a width of 800, I know that the right hand side of the screen is 800 minus 1, so that's 799. And the size of the ball is 50, so I'll subtract 50. Then we know that the ball has hit the right hand side of the screen, so move right now becomes 0, so the ball should now move to the left. I'll end the if statement there. So the right side of the screen is now done. So let's work on the left side of the screen. And I know that the left side of the screen is 0. So if X is less than or equal to 0, then the ball has hit the left side of the screen. So I need to have move right equal 1. I'll end the if statement. And now we just need the top and the bottom. The screen has a height of 600, so therefore Y is greater than or equal to 599, because 600 minus 1 is the bottom of the screen. I'll subtract 50 because the size of the ball is 50. Then move up should equal 1. I'll end the if statement. And for the top of the screen, we know that the screen starts at 0. So if Y is less than or equal to 0, then move up is equal to 0. End if. Okay, now that we have the hit detection in there, we have to move the ball based upon if move right is 1 or 0, and move up is 1 or 0, true or false. So if move right is equal to 1, then we know the ball is moving to the right, so X will equal X plus, we'll have it move 3 pixels at a time. Else, move right is 0, so therefore we're moving to the left, so I'll have to subtract, so X is equal to X minus 3. I'll end the if statement. So the last part is moving the ball up or down. So if move up is equal to 1, then we know that the ball is moving up. So Y equals Y minus 3. Else the ball is moving down. So move up would equal 0, which means we have to add to Y. So Y equals Y plus 3. I'll then end the if statement. And I'll bring this code back up. And now I'll go ahead and run and see if the ball bounces around the screen.